How can a tank equipped with reactive armor, advanced thermal sights, smoke grenades, and missile jamming technology still fail on the battlefield? The Russian T-90M, touted as a cutting-edge war machine, was expected to dominate. Yet, in the Russia-Ukraine war, it has been nothing short of a disaster. Despite its impressive specs on paper, the reality has been starkly different. What went wrong? As we all know, the T-90 entered service in 1993, but the extent to which this tank has been maintained and upgraded remains a question. Several reports reveal that the tank is equipped with advanced countermeasures, such as the Shtora 1 optronic system, an electro-optical active protection system designed to disrupt laser designators and rangefinders used by anti-tank missiles. The first series of T-90M tanks was deployed with Russian forces in early 2020, and this model is an evolution of the Cold War-era T-72 tank, underscoring Russia's commitment to enhancing its armored forces. Yuravagunzavod, the developer of the T-90M, stated that upgrades to this tank were heavily influenced by the ongoing war in Ukraine. They also noted that the T-90M has been updated with reinforced turrets, which could be a response to the widespread use of drones in the conflict. It's important to note that several innovations integrated into the T-90M bear a resemblance to upgrades the US Army has implemented on their Abrams tanks. For instance, the available specifications for the T-90 indicate that its 125mm smoothbore main gun can fire HEAT or high explosive anti-tank rounds, as well HEFRAG or high explosive fragmentation projectiles, enhancing its anti-personnel lethality. To some extent, this parallels the ammunition types used by the M1 Abrams, which include multi-purpose anti-tank rounds, heat shells, and canister rounds that release a series of small, fragmented projectiles to neutralize groups of enemy combatants. As previously mentioned, the T-90M is also equipped with the Shtora 1 optronic countermeasure system, designed to disrupt laser target designators and rangefinders from incoming anti-tank guided missiles. The Shtora 1 is an electro-optical jammer that interferes with the enemy's semi-automatic command-to-line-of-sight systems, laser rangefinders, and target designators. An essay published by the Federation of American Scientists Military Analysis Network states that the T-90M smoothbore cannon can fire time-fused projectiles, which may reflect the application of proximity fuses or modern airburst rounds. The paper also mentions that the T-90M is capable of firing a laser-guided missile called Reflex, designed to target armored objects and even low-flying helicopters, making it an effective counter-air weapon. This missile can penetrate up to 700 millimeters of resistance to hollow charge at ranges of up to 4,000 meters, providing the T-90M with the ability to engage vehicles and helicopters before they can pose a threat. The tank's computerized fire control system, laser rangefinder, and upgraded agate thermal sight enable it to engage targets effectively while on the move and during nighttime operations. The T-90M, despite being a significant improvement over its predecessors, still inherits design flaws commonly found in many Russian tanks. One of its major vulnerabilities is the location of its ammunition storage, which is placed under the turret. This design makes the tank particularly susceptible to direct hits from above, as its top armor is relatively thin. Such strikes can ignite the ammunition, triggering catastrophic explosions that endanger the crew and can even blow off the turret. This vulnerability has been increasingly evident on the battlefield in Ukraine, where numerous Russian T-90M tanks have been destroyed by anti-tank missiles fired from elevated positions by Ukrainian forces. These incidents highlight the lack of comprehensive 360-degree active protection systems on Russian tanks. While an essay by the Federation of American Scientists Military Analysis Network notes that the T-90 has been equipped with advanced thermal sights, uncertainty remains about the extent to which these tanks have been effectively maintained and upgraded. As a result, while the T-90 may have posed a significant threat in the 1990s, it is possible that inadequate maintenance and upgrades have diminished its effectiveness as a formidable weapon system today. Observations from the conflict in Ukraine support this theory, with numerous reports and documented instances showing Ukrainian forces successfully destroying T-90 tanks.